make the decision to leave the Senate. There's obviously important work to be done. There's important work that still remains to be done today, and there will be important work that remains to be done at the end of this Congress, but that will undoubtedly be true at the end of every future Congress as well. I think the simple truth is there's no ideal time to leave the Senate. I'm very proud of my service in the Senate, service to the people of New Mexico. I'm very proud of the work that my staff here in New Mexico does for the people of the state, have done and continue to do for the people of the state, and I'm proud of the work that my staff in Washington, D.C. Does for the people of New Mexico and for the nation. And we will continue with that through the remainder of this Congress. When I first started my work in the Senate in 1983, and Ann and John and I, and let me introduce them, I should have done that at the beginning, my wife Ann Bingaman right here, and our son John Bingaman, his fiancée Marlena Perrone, they're here with me today. But when Ann and John and I moved to Washington in 1983, it was never our thought that that was going to be a permanent move. And we had always considered New Mexico our home. We've cherished the time we've been able to spend in New Mexico during the nearly three decades since I went to serve in the Senate. And at the end of this term, we look forward to once again living in New Mexico and pursuing other challenges. So that was the statement I had, and I'm glad to answer any questions anyone has.
Senator, what's the biggest achievement of your long career in the U.S. Senate?
Well, I haven't tallied up what the various achievements are. I think we've done some good in a variety of areas, and I think we have a great opportunity to do some more good this year and next year in this final Congress. So I would like to get further into this final Congress, see what we're able to do, and give you a full accounting at that point.
What Senator, would you be why doing are you in stepping down? Sir? Why are you leaving right now after 28, 30 years by the time you step
well, down? After 30 years, I think I've given this my best effort, and I think this is a good time for me to make the decision. And so a lot of factors go into a decision like that, but this seems like the right time, and that's why I'm doing it now.
What do you look forward to doing in retirement, Senator?
I'm not sure what we're going to do. I'm not counting anything in, ruling anything in, or ruling anything out. I hope to find some other challenges that I can pursue, but I haven't settled on what those are yet.
You've got time.
Seems to have. We've got 22 months left in this Congress. There's a lot to still be done, and I look forward to making some progress on energy legislation in this Congress, on rewrite of the Elementary and Secondary Education Act in this Congress, and hopefully some initiatives to help get the economy going at a stronger rate than it has in the past.
Tom Udall will become the senior senator. Have you identified or thought of anyone that is ready to replace you in the Senate?
That's not a decision for me to make. That's a decision for the people of the state to make. Obviously, we've got a lot of capable people in public office today, and I think there'll probably be no shortage of folks interested in pursuing the job.
Anyone come to mind specifically?
I'm not going to give you a list, but I'm sure you can think of one.
Senator, in just an amazingly short time, the state is losing two very senior U.S. senators. Senator Domenici and yourself. We all know that Congress, especially the Senate, runs on seniority. Does it leave a kind of a void here in that kind of leadership for New Mexico?
Well, I think Tom Udall is senior, even though he was in the House for quite a period before coming to the Senate. I think we have a very capable congressional delegation. And I'm confident they can carry on. I think the state is in very good shape as far as its interests and what goes on in Washington today. The funding at the laboratories is strong, and the administration strongly supports that. So the military facilities around the state, the same thing. A lot of other activities going on in New Mexico. I went through a whole listing of that at the speech I gave to the state legislature here a few weeks ago. And I think New Mexico is in very good shape that way. And obviously we need to see our economy strengthen, but that's true nationwide.
What did Harry Reid tell you when you told him last night about your plans for today?
He told me he was sorry that I made the decision, but he could understand it, and he looked forward to working with me over the next 2 years to get all done that we could get done.
How concerned are you about what your absence will do to the control in the Senate if the D's don't hang on to your seat?
I think the D's will hang on to my seat, and I'm going to do all I can, of course, to ensure that this remains a Democratic seat.
Senator, have you had a chance to talk to President Obama about this? And if so, what was his reaction?
I talked to Bill Daley, his chief of staff, an hour or so ago, and asked him to convey this information to the president, but I haven't spoken to the president myself.
And what did he say when you told him?
Well, he said the same thing Harry Reid did.
Mm-hmm. Do you have any regrets?
Regrets in what regard? About the decision or about what I've done in the Senate or about
what you've done in the Senate?
Oh, I mean, I could think of a few votes that I probably would cast differently if I had to do it again. But I think by and large, I'm very proud of the representation I've been providing to the state, and I hope to continue that for this year and next.
Senator, a lot of political figures, especially if they've been involved in politics for many years, have said the tone in Washington has changed dramatically in recent years. Is that a factor in the decision to leave?
Well, there's a lot of factors that go into a decision like this. It's a personal decision, and those are the main factors, the personal decisions.
Can you elaborate on that a little bit, and just maybe three bullet points as to why you want to?
No, I think at some point in any one of these jobs, you come to a point where you think you've made your best effort, and it's time to move on and allow someone else to serve. And that's the point that I've arrived at.
You helped draft the health care legislation also.
Go ahead, Nancy. Go ahead.
So you helped draft the health care legislation also. Is that something that you are very proud of as well?
No, I think that's very important legislation for the country. I think it's going to be a very great benefit to New Mexico. And I'm going to do all I can over the next couple of years to be sure that gets implemented in an appropriate way.
It's a lot different than when you came back in 83, the relationships among your colleagues, the cajoliality or whatever. Is that, when you talk about the personal, is the Senate a different institution? Did that play a role in your decision to retire?
No, I think there's the Senate is still a congenial place, and civility reigns in the Senate. When I got elected, I remember I was on one of the morning talk shows with the other senators who were elected, and they did a little introduction before they interviewed us, and the guy said, you know, the Senate operates on the principle of senatorial courtesy, just like the Longshoremen's Union. And I think that was true in 83. That's still true.
Senator, do you think in deciding not to run that you'll be able to maybe take some risks on some contentious votes that makes it possible because you're not running for reelection?
Well, I think I have taken some risks on some contentious votes. I expect to continue doing that.
Do you think it'll make it any easier, though?
Well, I don't know that it makes it any easier, but you know, I think when I look back at the 28 years of voting I already have on my record, I think some of those are fairly contentious votes and weren't always the popular thing to do.
Senator Domenici and his wife Nancy elected to stay in D.C. Will you maintain the family home there, or do you plan to move?
We plan to move to Santa Fe. We have our home in Santa Fe. We had before we went to Washington, and we enjoy it very much, and we plan to live in Santa Fe.
Senator, is this a retirement, or are you leaving it open to go back to work in public?
No, private? No, I expect to find some other things to do. I just don't know what they are.
Pues esto, un decisión mucho más difícil que su decisión en ochenta y tres entrar en
los dos decisiones eran muy difícil en 83 y este año también.
¿En qué sentido? ¿En qué sentido?
Son decisiones muy importantes para el Estado, pero también para mí y mi familia. I better stop at that. I'm sure I'll foul up here. Try anymore.
Senator, all right. About the Senate you might miss?
Oh, there's lots of things I'm going to miss about the Senate. But as I say, I've still got 22 months of service ahead, and I look forward to that and think we can get some things accomplished.
Senator, your staff calls you Jeff. They don't call you Senator Bingaman. What's a message that you want to give to all of your staff that has been with you? A lot of them.
Well, my staff is what has made whatever success I've had possible. I've been very fortunate, both in Washington and here in New Mexico, to have terrific staff. And many of them have been with me for a very long period of time. And I get a lot of feedback from people in New Mexico appreciating the good work that my staff does. And, we want that to continue for the next 2 years as well.
Aside from your family, was Harry Reid the first person to know that you had made that decision?
I think that's probably right.
Well, I missed
what No, that's not right. Some of my staff knew.
I missed what you said he said, Harry Reid.
Well, he just said that he was sorry that I'd made the decision, but he could understand it, and respected it, and he looked forward to working with me this year and next year to try to get some things done. Well, thank you all for coming. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Yeah.